In this lesson, we are going to use this infrared obstacle avoidance, and we will see how can we detect an obstacle for infrared ray that hits the object. We are going to modify the code as well as adding a buzzer, so when the obstacle is detected, the buzzer will turn on. Let's see if we can adjust it and increase the sensitivity. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. In this lesson, we are going to learn about this infrared obstacle avoidance sensor, where we will detect an object if it is on the path. Here is how it works. We have infrared LED or transmitter, which transmits infrared ray that hits the object and reflects back. Then we have photodiode or infrared receiver, where it receives the signal and detects it, and it will we will amplify it using an op amp or operational amplifier, and we detect it. This is the power. When you connect it to power, regardless, this will be always on, and this LED will turn on when the obstacle is detected. This will output always high or one when there is nothing. When the obstacle is detected, this is turned on and the output goes to zero or low. So zero means an object and one means nothing. So right now there is nothing, but the light is off. When light is off, we get one. When light is on, we get zero. This is a transmitter. It emits infrared light, and when this black is the receiver, and the receiver will receive it and we will amplify it. We will also set the sensitivity using this variable resistor, and that determines if you want to make it very short or the maximum long range that it can detect. Here is the lesson. We can read it at obstacle avoidance, at learning project 3 and 3.3. Here is the wiring picture. V out is connected to pin 2, ground is to ground, and VCC we will connect it to 5 volts. And here the actual wiring diagram. Again, the pin that is on the other side, this will be connected using green wire to pin 2. The middle one is ground using black wire connected to ground, and the right pin is VCC. We will connect it using red wire to 5 volts. And here is the actual wiring. Right pin is connected to pin 2 using green wire. The middle is ground. It's connected to ground. The right pin is red, connected to pin 5. And let's open the code by clicking File, Open. Go to the folder that you have downloaded, click 3-in-1 kit, learning project, and come to 3.3. Detect the obstacle and detect the obstacle and then open it. So this is our code. The code is very simple. We are defining pin 2 as IR obstacle pin of type integer. Inside the setup, we are initializing the serial monitor with 9600 baud. And this line is setting that pin 2 as input. So we are receiving input. And because we have used pin mode on pin 2, this is just digital. Inside the loop, we are reading the that pin, the pin 2 in here, using digital read. The result of this, which is either the result of this is 1 or 0, will be detected. The value will be detected and will be printed using the serial print LN on the serial monitor, and we have 10 millisecond delay, and the loop will continuously does the same thing. Now let's open the serial monitor. As you can see, we are reading 1. Okay, so here is a serial monitor, and if I bring my hand away, you can see that we are reading here 1. As soon as I bring my hand, you will see that we are reading 0. If I go back, let's see up to what distance it can read. So more than this, it cannot read. But here, read, yeah, now it cannot read, and then read. So I'm gonna put this ruler in terms of centimeter so we can see it. And here, I'm gonna put this LoRa module here exactly at about 1 millimeter further away, but that's my obstacle. So as you can see, we are detecting here 0. The light is on, it has detected. Let's go backwards. So I have to zoom out. And here, again, let's go back. How much I should go backwards? So I'm gonna put the ruler back because it was not fitting on the screen, so you could see it. Now we are at 12 centimeter, as you can see, 120 millimeters. And we are now at 13, we are going back. So almost 15. As you can see, at 15, it's turning on and off. But keep in mind that this is very shiny. If it's a dull object, it might get better result. I'm going to put the SunFounder Arduino kit box. We are at exactly 13. So 13 and 14, it just turns off. So maximum 12 centimeter is very reliable. Now let's try to adjust it. You see, at 12 and a half or 13, it's on, and then it's off. Let's see if we can adjust it and increase the sensitivity. Maybe it's being decreased. If the light turns on, no, I went all the way to clockwise, counterclockwise, it stopped, going back. So now I increase it to 15, as you can see. So now we are at 15 centimeters. Let's go back further. 18 and see if it works. Now at 20 it doesn't work, but 18 centimeter it works. Amazing. So 20 centimeter, exactly 20 centimeter, it works. But if I put the angle, if it's straight, it's the surface, the angle of incident is 90 degrees, we are getting. But if I put it a little up, we are not reading. Oh, we are reading. So as you can see, we can increase or decrease the sensitivity. Now we are going to modify the code as well as adding a buzzer. So when the obstacle is detected, the buzzer will turn on. And here is the code to detect obstacle. This was part of the code. I have defined alarm pin as pin 3, and I have defined a sense value where we will hold the value for the sensor. Inside the setup, I have added this line where the alarm pin is defined as an input. Sorry, it should be output. So we are turning the buzzer on, and inside the loop we are reading the pin, the sensor value, and saving it in the sensor. After that, we are using conditional statement using if, and we check if sense value is equal low. These two equal sign mean compare it. If it is low or zero, this low means zero, then we print this on the screen which says obstacle. And then also we use digital write, the alarm pin. We send high signal or 5 volts to this pin, so the buzzer starts buzzing. Else mean otherwise, which is not low, which means it is high, then we send the pin to low, so the buzzer is off. And then the loop will continue to do the same thing. And this is the wiring for the buzzer. The buzzer's longer pin is on this side. I'm inserting it to the breadboard. The first wire is from the positive. This is coming to pin 3 of Arduino. The ground, the left pin on the other side, will be connected to ground in here. And here is a project demonstration. The light is off. There is nothing printed on the serial monitor. When I bring my hand, you can see the buzzer is running, and also the information is printed. If you want it, you can omit it, but so perfectly working. To just remind you that you don't need to connect to USB or to computer, you just need to connect your battery as well, and the project will perfectly work fine with battery.